Hello everyone, Kille Kadovan here playing Pro Cycling Manager 2017. We are in Giro d'Italia, but sadly disaster have come. It looks like we are not feeling well. Decrease in energy. Fitness dropped to 90%. Still above 90, so guess it is okay. Fitness peak 98.4 points. Probably after the next stage we will be in the fitness peak. Let's look at what we have to ride today. Stage 10, very important time trial. 39.2 kilometers, a very long one. So it's going to be a tough one. We would have liked to use the fitness peak for this race, for this stage. Would have been a big boost in our performance. Then stage 11, a hilly stage with some very tough climbs. But we can see it's downhill and flat towards the goal line. So maybe we can attack in this last bit here of in the middle of the downhill. And then stage 12 is a flat stage. We need a good performance on stage 10. We really need to show our strength here. We are on the start line. We are ready to get this stage rolling. I'm gonna go 71 effort here early on, see where that takes us. We want to have a lot of energy towards the end, and maybe some in the middle here as well. My teammate, Brian Dillon, is Dylan Bryan, is actually in third place at the moment. Very strong riding by him. Jeffrey Conan is in 16th place. He did not use his yellow bar very well. He ran out quite early. But still in 16th place, very impressive. How are we faring? We are getting closer to that first time check. Yellow bar is decently healthy, but I would like it to be a little bit more healthy. So we're gonna go down to 70 effort. I think that's fine, and we're gonna up the pace to X4 for a little bit. Now we are just gonna take this time check, and we are 64th place, 40 seconds behind. That is expected since we've been riding rather slow. Let's actually see. It is Tom Dumoulin in the lead here, just ahead of Jeffrey Conan for the first time check. That is a sign that Conan emptied himself way too early. Tom Dumoulin is yet to finish, so we'll see how he will fare soon enough. We are starting to get into this first climb. Actually, let's do 75 for this bit of the climb. But we can see there are some orange parts here as well. Maybe for those we can go up to 80 or 85. I am guessing one of them is about to start now. Race day conditioning is zero, and you can see that this injury is still plaguing us. Hopefully, it will just be today. Let's go down to 75 again. Yellow bar still very healthy. And then up to 85 for a bit. Not very long this time. And then we go down to 75 again. Hopefully, this will benefit us getting closer to the other people for this time check. Still no Tom Dumoulin to finish. See, Tom Dumoulin got a massive lead here at the second time check. Kwiatkowski in second place and Jeffrey Konan in third. Feel like we are going much stronger now. Now some downhill. Do we need to go down a little bit in speed for the downhill? Yeah, let's do 72. Let's do 72 until the next time check, and then we can speed up the game. Now maybe 4x. The speed 8x were a bit too much. Feel like our yellow bar is in a good position. We want that strength for that last bit of climb. Let's do 75 for a bit. And we are 17th place, 1 minute and 18 seconds behind, leading up to the second time check. That is not well enough. We need to improve quite a lot. Or maybe even more than that. We are actually going to see this objective, stage objective, finish top three. That is the same as we are expected to finish top three in the general classification at the end of Giro d'Italia as well. So a lot of pressures on us, but hopefully a lot of the people ahead of us here in the for a second time check ran out of strength in that final bit of climb. And we will not do that. We will have a lot of energy coming into the climb and we will make full use of it. Should we go 80 effort left for the start? Yeah, let's do 80. Maybe we need to go up to 85. I feel 85 is totally fine at the moment. Maybe we need to even go 90 for a bit. 2.5 kilometers left to go. Tom Dumoulin got a 51 second lead in the when he finished. Edgar Klaus in second place. Kwiatkowski in third place. Let's do 95. We might even be able to do 99 for a little bit. Looks like 95 will be perfect. Perfect finish. And we are in third place. 39 seconds behind Tom Dumoulin. But Tom Dumoulin was a monster today. Dino Saverl also beat us. The other guy competing for the youth jersey. But I feel like this will be third place on this day for us. Because the people that started behind us are not as strong as us in a time trial. We need to watch this now. Because with a bit of luck, we might be the new leader. We might be in the pink jersey. Yes! We have the pink jersey! Absolutely amazing. 45 seconds ahead of Wout Poels. 48 seconds ahead of Bauke Mollema. And 1 minute and 10 seconds ahead of Luis Menches. Wow! That was super important. We managed to take the goal of third place on the stage. And we also managed to take first place in Giro d'Italia general classification. Wow, that was super important. And if I say so myself, quite impressive. 11th place for the points jersey. 13th place for the mountain jersey. And even if we lose a bit of time on Dino today, we still have a massive lead in the youth jersey. Oof. That was a very important stage for us, a very good stage for us. And I feel like we are ready to defend this jersey now. Preview for stage 11. We're not among the favorites to win the stage. But our fitness peak have started. Absolutely amazing. Ooh. You can see that we have an illness. We can actually see illness decrease in energy phase 2. Not sure what phase 2 means, but it's not good for us that we are injured that we are ill. But we are still expected to have plus 3 to the race day conditioning. Very, very nice. We need to be careful today. Whew. Focus is to defend the jersey, but if we can win the stage, that will be... This might be a good stage to be able to do that on, actually. So let's get into the race. And how nice is this? Pink jersey is on our shoulders. And even if we are ill, we're still having a plus 2 race day conditioning. And our attributes are slightly improved. Actually nice to see them improve that much. Very tough climbs today. We need to be careful. So that we do not get stuck behind on either of the climbs. That last bit in the middle of the downhill. That is where I said I wanted to attack. So let's see if we can do that. We're almost at the top of this last climb. The pace is rather high. 44 people in this group. It went down to 41 now. So a lot of people are struggling. There have been quite a lot of falls today as well. I only fell once. It was in the downhill here on the second big climb. But no serious damage for me. It looked like I could get back into the peloton straight away. You can see Gerard is having a very tough day today. He might not make it in time. We are at the peak here, 43 people. Very glad that Brian managed to survive together with me. He can protect me until 25 people in this group now, so I absolutely need to attack in that last bit of climb. We are getting close to it. Should I do 95? When is the turn? The turn should be in this corner. There we are. We are climbing. I'm gonna attack. I'm gonna let the Brian be on his own. Luis Menchez is trying to follow. Cano is trying to follow. Mollema is trying to follow. Pools is trying to follow. We are going all out here in this climb. But it looks like everyone is able to follow me. What the hell? I thought it was a good attack. So, nothing gained from the attack. Nothing gained at all. Actually, Luis Menchez is attacking instead. Luis Menchez is attacking instead. I need to make sure he is caught. What the hell, Luis Menchez? That was not cool. Brian is coming up to help me pull the pack. Luis Menchez have been caught. I'm gonna use the energy gel now, even if it's 8.5 kilometers left to go. Because it's mostly downhill, so I feel like it's going to go rather fast. 31 people in this group. The breakaway will win. Not sure who is in the absolute front. Oh, we are back to full strength. 4.5 kilometers left to go. Let's do 99 effort. Let's move up to the front here. Let's start leading out the pack. Duchest wins the stage. Jose Gonzalez in second place. We are leading out the pack. 1 kilometer left to go. Let's start the sprint. We're gonna finish first. We get stuck behind someone. Of course, Brian comes in ahead of us. Oh, we can see it's a bit bugged, but that's totally fine. Fifth place for us today. Dylan takes fourth place. There were probably no gaps, so that's a strong finish. Either way, fifth place, I'm totally happy with that. Fifth place on the stage, Duchest manages to win it from a breakaway. A bit sad that we got stuck behind, I think it was Madrasu, so Dylan could pass us. That means we didn't get as many points as we could have. Still, we are in sixth place now. Very nice to see that. Maybe there are a lot of tough stages in this Giro d'Italia, so maybe we will be able to place very high here. Mountain points, we didn't get any points from the mountains today. Oof, still in the lead in the general classification, nothing changed for any of the top riders. Let's get into stage 12. Stage 12. Mostly flat. You can see the second half of the stage is very flat, even if there are two big climbs about in the middle of the stage. We are having a +3 day, but we are still ill. I feel like today we need to take it very easy. There will just be a mass sprint and we will probably not work that hard to get a good placement today. 15 kilometers left to go for my group. The breakaway is still out there, 3 minutes and 36 seconds ahead of us. They will win today. Sad news, Jeffrey Conan, my teammate, he had to withdraw today early on in the stage. Very sad to see that happen. My team have still been working very hard together with Lotto today. Previously, it's mostly been Dimension Data that have helped us, but today Lotto wanted to do a lot of work as well. More than 10 kilometers left to go. Feel like the pace is very slow since we are not battling for the stage win. Maybe that means I can attack, create a gap, but we still get 17 seconds, 18 seconds. Feel like we can go 99 effort until the end here. We're gonna take the energy gel. 5 kilometers left to go. We have a small gap. There we go. The sprint is on. But once the sprinters starting to move, I think they're gonna eat us up super fast. We do not stand a chance to win the stage. Let's start the sprint. Igor Boev wins the stage. Never heard of him actually. And we can see the sprinters are just moving past us. 15th place I think is 1 point, and that will go to Bauhaus. And we are in 26th place. Stage 12. Quite a bad stage for us. Even if we come in 26th place, the bad thing is that Conan had to withdraw. Kurt Nielsen also, Simon Yates, Edward Toons, Fernando Gaviria. A lot of strong people had to withdraw on this stage. Let's first look at here. Nothing changed in the general classification. But the points jersey, wow. The two top people had to withdraw. Now it is Duchesne in the lead ahead of Canola. And we are in 6th place. We might be able to win this jersey as well now. Mountain jersey, nothing changed at all. Oof, a great episode. Still, we take the pink jersey for Giro d'Italia. 35 seconds ahead of Pools. What an amazing accomplishment. Can we keep this going? Oof, 9 stages left to go. They will come up in the 3 next episodes. Until then, I'm Killer Cow Divine. Thank you all for watching.